For Mesh Rashi people, the eclipse is happening in the third house. Now Rahu assumes the form of Tamra. As per the Murti Nirnaya, he becomes a Tamra Murti. The third house transit of Rahu is good. The eclipse in third house is not so great. Add to that, heavyweights Jupiter and Saturn, they are in Capricorn, that is 10th house. Both these planets are retrograde. So what will happen is, naturally, during this time, for Mesh Rashi people, there will be some danger to the siblings. So when I say siblings, sister, brother, both of them, there'll be, especially the siblings, would be prone to accidents, to injuries. They might have a, they might fall down, they might injure themselves. It could be any of these things. So it is important to make sure that your respective brothers and sisters are taken care of. You will also have a lot of career related problems. Especially, for example, if this is a time for promotion, you will not be considered for promotion. You would be fighting with your bosses. This is also the time, especially those people who are vulnerable, who are in the borderline, they are prone to layoffs. So be extremely cautious about your career. Make sure you don't unnecessarily fight with your boss. Be attentive and give your 100%, or I would say give your 150% in your career so that things are stable at your end. Your relationships with your guru or your mentors, these things will come under some heat. There will be unnecessary fights that might happen. The relationships might become a little strained. So be careful in that regard as well. So from a remedial perspective, at the time of the eclipse, here are two things you need to do. One is, do the Ganesha Japam, Om Gam Ganapataye Namaha, and follow up with either of the two mantras that I am going to share. The first one is Om Namo Narayanaya. If you are going to do this, then you will have to use a Tulsi Mala and do this in multiples of 108. The second mantra that you could do is Om Namah Shivaya. If you choose to do this mantra japam, then use Rudraksha Mala. Again, do it in multiples of 108. Now, once the eclipse is over, you need to do a couple of things. First and foremost, take some Tur Dal and donate it to the poor. Now, the effects of the eclipse usually are there from between 3 to 6 months. But since this is an annular eclipse, you can safely say it is going to be there for 3 months. So donate Tur Dal. You can donate it on any day possible. Try to donate it as many times as possible to the poor. Second one, make sure any conversations that you do within your colleagues, with your boss, etc., be careful and be cautious about what you are talking. Your emotional outbursts might sometime take over, and the conversations that you have with your bosses, with the people who appraise or review you, would become a little bad. So be careful there. Third, recite Hanuman Chalisa and recite this every day if possible. Again, you can recite this any part of the day or any part of the night, whatever is convenient for you, but recite this every day.